Show them in. Ah, Oliver, good of you to have come.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Well, who is this we have here?
Oh, Mr. President, this is my good friend Annie. She so wanted to meet you that I couldn't resist bringing her along just to say hello.
Annie? Of course, the little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
Annie, this is President Roosevelt.
How do you do, President Roosevelt?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sounded on the radio.
Thank you, President Roosevelt.
Well, shall we begin?
Yes, Annie, if you'll wait outside.
No, Oliver, let Annie stay. Having a child on hand will keep us on our best behavior.
Well, thank you, Mr. President.
Harold, I don't want to hear so much as a gosh out of you. Oliver, you know everyone, of course, but Annie, let me introduce you. Secretary of Labor Perkins, Secretary of State Hall, Acting Secretary of the Treasury Morgenthau, Secretary of the Interior Hickeys, and my friend and aide, Mr. Louis Hockney. Now, Oliver, since you seem to speak for those happy few Americans who have any money left, I'd like to begin with your view on matters.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge, the business of this country is business. And for your good, the good of the country, for Wall Street, and the good of me, and we have to get my factories open and get those workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 15 million Americans out of work, and nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more distressing each day. There could be more.
Germany, hell, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run...
Poor hell, for people who are starving, there is no long run.
The trouble is, it's all happening at once. The stock market has taken another nosedive.
Riots, floods, sit-down strikes. And the
Ray start?
Well, it looks like the Hour of Smiles had more listeners than we thought, Ian.
Hundreds of couples? One of them is bound to be my mother and father.
Well, as much as I'm enjoying your company, Oliver, and especially yours, Annie, I suspect you'd better be getting back to New York immediately.
Well, thank you, Mr. President, if you don't mind. Annie?
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Annie. Goodbye.
No, Annie, thank you. You're the kind of person a president should have around you.
Mr. President, what if we set up 100 or 1,000 new projects?
Then highways.
New post offices.
Put the unemployed to work building.
We can create 5 million new jobs in 6 months.
And with the paycheck, get all the millions off the even back and pay taxes.
We'll build a country so strong that nobody, not even Chancellor Hitler, can beat us in a war.
The FBI caught Baby Face, and they'll slip out.
What we've got to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A new concept. A new dedication.
A new horizon.
A new spirit.
A new attitude.
A new deal. Perkins, gentlemen, I was right the first time. The only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Things else that you should know.
I made me a fortune, that fortune may tend. Been headlined and profiled again and again. But something was missing, I never quite knew. That something was someone, but who? My speeches are greeted with thunderous acclaim, and to universities bearing my name. Yet something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone, but who?
Of course. Left Andy at the seems to be.
Oh, she is, she is. Well, if you begin to edit things together, we'll be taking her along now.
Take her?
No!
Just a moment, Mr. Mudge. What about the money?
Money? Well, we don't got much, but we'd be glad to give you whatever you think.
You mean to tell me that you don't know that I've offered a certified check in the amount of $50,000 to anyone who could prove that they were Annie's parents?
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check. Anyway, we don't want no money.
Right, we don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that little big farm up in New Jersey? Well, $50,000 we could afford to raise Annie upright out in the country with lots of fresh air and fresh chickens and...
Fresh ham?
Fresh ham. Certified, huh? All I gotta do is make it out to myself.
That's correct. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Well, certainly you wouldn't mind leaving Annie here overnight and until Christmas morning, and then you could come pick her up and your check.
Oh!
Well, whatever you prefer, sir. We better be getting along back to the hotel now. Bye, Annie.
Bye, Antelope.
Just long gone, and then you're going to spend the rest of your life with us. Well, so long, all. Whoops! Bye, me, Dolly. Merry Christmas.
Season's greetings.
Well, that is wonderful news.
Yes. Wonderful news.
Annie has found her mother and father, and they seem to be a very nice couple.
Yes, very nice.
You're lucky, Annie.
Right. I'm lucky. Just think. New Jersey.
Great.
Yes, sir.
Champagne.
Yes, sir.
Well, we have to celebrate. Besides, it's Christmas Eve, and... Well, we've just received the most wonderful news in the whole world. Annie has found her real mother and father. And I would like to propose a toast. To Annie Mudge.
Cheers to Annie Mudge.
You're up early. I've got something very difficult to tell you, and the President has offered to help me tell it to you. Mr. President,
Yesterday.
Come off it, Andy.
Yeah. anymore.
Hooray!
And you're going to have classrooms and teachers. Wonderful new life. I know.